Welcome to the SCP Foundation Integrated File Server. To begin, please insert your Foundation personnel badge into the card reader. Authorization. Approved. Please select item's numerical code to view. Processing. Your file is ready to view.
The Association of Entities That Never Did Exist. This meeting of 10 will now come to order. Frederick Starbuck, the protagonist of a sci-fi novel that had it all copies destroyed, banged a nut gavel on a non-existent podium. The unnamed child will read off the minutes of the last meeting. The unnamed child, a character from a children's book that never existed, stood up. First order of business at the last meeting was celebrating the passage of Cecil DeMuth into the realm of fiction. He was featured as an incidental character in a short story written by a college student. There was some polite applause. Next, we discussed the matter of actively attempting to enter narratives, much in the same way young Frederick did so many years ago. After that, the tentacled mass and President Starbuck debated the merits of cannibalism amongst nevers, and whether it should be banned entirely, or encouraged to get rid of threats to the non-existent community. Finally, we voted on whether or not the newest initiate in our group, Tilios, should be made a full member. The eyes had it. Welcome Tilios, son of Hermes, god of television. The tentacled mass screeched their approval about finally having another deity on the association. For some reason, despite never speaking, everyone understood it. Tilios, a young man with hair fashioned into a style reminiscent of an old rabbit ear antenna, simply blushed. I'm humbled to be in such an association, really. I'd not heard of Tent before I stumbled into the Knot Room last week. We're glad to have you here on the Association of Entities That Never Did Exist, Tilios. Ivory Ebony smiled at him, flashing teeth that were half white, half black. Tell us a little about yourself. The meeting ended before you got a proper introduction. Well, like the unnamed child said, I'm meant to be the son of Hermes, god of communication. I was going to be worshipped by a group of hermetic revivalists in New York City, but the leader of the cult died before he could write up anything about me. I've been one of our kind for about 7 Earth years, now. Tilios sighed, and sniffed a bit. I never existed, and I probably never will exist. And how does that make you feel, Tilios? Starbuck asked. Honestly? Pretty damn bitter. It's not fair that my creator died before he got a chance to write a single word about me. Now, I'm condemned to wander the ways for the rest of eternity, unless someone somehow inserts me into a narrative. The tentacled mast screeched. How did I find this place? I just stumbled into here one day, and found the meeting in session. It's quite nice here, really, compared to some other parts of the ways. Well, I'm glad you like it. So Karthar, king of the solar city of Mguan, treasurer of Tend, smiled at Delios. How do you like the concepts of beverages? They go quite well with the non-existent donuts, I must say. Everyone in the room chuckled. There were only 10 never-weir in the association. Some of them humanoid, but most of them were something else. So Karthar was a being made entirely out of plasma, and the aforementioned tentacled mass was just that. A tentacled mass dreamed up by either Lovecraft or one of his contemporaries. There was debate over which it was. That had not been committed to paper before the author had died. Anyway. The cult I was meant to be worshipped by, Delios continued, was led by a man named Trevor Sonatina. He had become obsessed with Greek mythology, particularly the myths involving the god Hermes. He was convinced that Hermes was the only Olympian that had survived into the modern day because, as god of messengers, he was able to thrive on all the communications technology in the modern world. I nearly met Hermes, once. Everyone in the Knot Room but Elios groaned. Ivory Ebony loved to brag about mythological beings and famous figures she almost met. I saw the back of his head as he came out of the library, once. The ball of tentacles screeched in response. It's true. I did. More screeching from the writhing mass. Moving on. Shall we recite the oath? Indeed. Starbuck lead the other nevers in the oath of Tend. We are ideas without form. We are not much better than chaos. We never were, and never will be. We will govern this chaos, even if we are not heard. We are the association of entities that never did exist, and we are order amongst the never were. The first item on the agenda, said the unnamed child, is the fact that an increasingly large amount of members from the group that the library calls the Book Burners are using the ways, and attempting to destroy Neverers. What shall our course of action be? We shall now take a short recess. Starbuck banged the knock gavel, and everyone got up. Ivory started talking to the tentacled mass, who had some less than nice things to say about Ivory. They had started a bit of a shouting match when the topic of eldritch deities came up. Shove it up. Do you even have an ass? If so, shove it up there. Anti-brain. Ivory slapped the mass across what she thought was the face. The unnamed child looked at Ivory. What's hentai? Ivory blinked, and cursed to herself. Turning around, she said in a sweet tone, you're too young to know that, sweetie. She smiled innocently, and patted her on the head. I'm older than you. I've been around since the 1950s. I've just never been published. Don't be patronizing, you bi-colored hag. If you're so old, why don't you calm down? Starbuck aimed a laser pistol up into the air, if directions such as up could apply here. We're all non-existent here, we're all on equal terms. The bickering continued. Starbuck fired off a couple of shots to no effect, and then tried to separate the two bickering not entities. Tilios sat in his chair and sighed, drumming his fingers against the knot table. Why were never we're so batty? He looked around the knot room and hello, was that a wall? It was. And it had a gigantic number 4 on it. What on earth? Walking around the commotion, he went up to the wall and tapped on it. A brick came loose, and on the other side, he saw son of a bitch. Everyone, shut up for a second. The bickering continued. I said shut up. It went on. Ivory threw a punch at Sokarth, who had gotten involved due to Starbuck saying something nasty about plasmoid beings, and Elios had to duck under flying concept of a chair. Finally, at the top of his lungs, Tilios bellowed. I may not exist, but I am still a god, and I command you all to stop. Everyone stopped dead in their tracks and stared at Tilios. What is the meaning of this? Asked the unnamed child. Someone's writing about us. Or has written about us, the tentacled mast screeched at the not god. I can feel it. And since someone's writing about us. Ivory stared, her jaw dropping. My god. We exist. Maybe you do, said an incidental character in the corner who had not yet been mentioned in the narrative. I haven't even gotten a name yet. Well, you were just mentioned, so there's that. Tilios smiled. Hold on. There are 10 of us here. How many of us have been named? Starbuck counted on his fingers. There's me, Ivory, Sokarth, you, the unnamed child, the character in the corner. Oh, and Cthulhu's hairball? The tentacled mast screeched. What? It's a name, isn't it? That leaves 3 that still haven't been mentioned in the narrative. Well? It's not like they can do anything, reasoned the unnamed child. If they attack us, they'll be mentioned in the narrative, and therefore, will exist. Ow. The metafiction levels of this story are making my brain hurt. Dial it back a bit, guys? Screw you, narrator. Shouted an 8th character, plucked from a fanfiction that would never be written, and with good reason, it was quite horrible. It could have been quality if it hadn't been based off of Doctor Who. That just leaves me, expounded a stout gentleman with a boiler hat, and whoever this 10th fellow is. Me? Said the 10th individual. I am no one. I am never we're. Everyone stared at the 10th individual, who was, quite simply. I can't say he was indescribable, because that would mean he had a description. You're all never we're. Hold it, though. Tilios pointed up to the previous line of dialogue. How can you be a never weir if you were mentioned in the story? That just makes you a war. The never weir gave a cry, and disappeared in a poof of logic. Starbuck frowned. Well, that settles that, I guess. Now what? Now, I say we get some actual beverages instead of just concepts of them. And donuts? The incidental character smiled. I've always wanted to try an actual donut. The nine remaining walked out of the now actualized room, through the ways, and towards the library.
Thank you.